Hey again, everybody. All right, so let's jump right into the next one really quick. And before I do, I want to show the dual X symmetry trick this time. But before I do, I forgot to mention in the last video, if you come down here to make mesh, that's going to be what you hit when you're done making your array. If you want it to all be, you know, sculptable and move this all around separately. Until you hit make mesh, you're working on one and the rest will follow. With that said, you know, because I was only moving it up and down on the world axis there, if you skew it, you know, you can get a whole bunch of different results. Like, you know, maybe you want like a spiral type of deal going on, or maybe it's hungry. It's going to eat you. It's going to eat me. Oh, God. Okay. Anyways. So that's pretty cool there. Just to show you, you know, that you can come in here and you could even take that whole thing and then repeat it in a circular pattern like I showed you. And it just gets ridiculous. But anyhow, moving on to the subject of this video, which is, okay, so real quick, I just want to mention, if you are working in array mesh and you have it turned on, and hold on, let me turn. I have dynamic subdivision. No, I don't. Okay. Thought I had the dynamic subdivision turned on. But, okay. So if you are working in array mesh, what I wanted to say is if you ever click on the subtool to switch to it and you're trying to sculpt on it, it's like nothing's happening. That's because you're sculpting on the wrong one. Just hit polyframe or shift F or your polyframe button right here. And whichever one has the wireframe showing, that's the one that is going to be affected. So as you can see, whatever I'm doing to this one is happening to that one across the x-axis, okay? But the cool thing is if I turn local symmetry on now, since this thing is completely symmetrical all the way down the middle, it's using its bounding box to determine the local symmetry. And if you were in 2023 or beyond, you could even set the gizmo to sculpt symmetrically wherever the gizmo is placed. So that's some pretty cool functionality in 2023. It's very, very cool. Just one another just quick tangent. Not really tangent, but I just want to say that I do my best. I'm going to do my best in my videos to compensate those who have upgraded and those who have not. I only have 2022.0.8. I might upgrade soon. We'll see. But I do keep up with all the latest features and functionality, even if I don't have it. So I'll always mention that. All right. So moving back to this, we're going to be using local symmetry in this case. And you can see since the array is mirrored across the x-axis, basically you have, you know, sculpt in real time dual X, like you're sculpting symmetrically locally and it's mirroring it over to that side. And there's no reason that you need to do this. It just helps me to visualize it. So I like this method. Even if I was sculpting a human leg, for instance, I would like to use this method and then break the symmetry where it needs broken and bent, you know, like turn symmetry off and come in here with the move brush. And if this was a human leg, you know, maybe, you know, move parts where they need moving after the fact. It's just, it's the same thing as sculpting a face and then, you know, keeping it symmetrical and then breaking symmetry afterward, you know, with the details and stuff. I just prefer it. And this way you can even, like, you can't mirror and weld a subdivided model. You know, you can, but you have to, like, delete the subdivisions and then rebuild them and after you mirror and weld and all that. So this is just a cool way to sculpt symmetrically and visualize it across the x-axis. And this huge arm, where'd it go? Well, I had a huge arm here because I wanted to show what happens if you don't lock position and lock size, which is, so I'll just showcase. Anyways, let me show you how to get this actually set up real quick. And that would be, it's the same thing as the other thing I showed. You would go to array mesh and I'm going to reset it. Okay. So we don't have anything there now hitting. So remember, if you want to turn transpose on, you can visualize where the pivot point is. And there we go. There's the big boy. So this is what happens when I turn lock position and lock size off after the fact. Okay, so that's why I kind of tend to use it more often than not. There's some instances where having it exponentially grow as you're rotating or whatever, that could be awesome. But yeah, so, but if you lock position, lock size, reset, okay, that's going to move the pivot point, as you can see, to the world center up here, and then you just hit mirror X mirror, okay? And that's going to throw it across the X axis according to where the pivot point is. So if you turn lock position, lock size off, and hit reset, and then X mirror, since this thing is pretty much perfectly symmetrical down the center, you're not going to see any difference, okay? So it's trying to mirror it across right where this is, across X. So again, lock position, lock size, reset. That throws the pivot up here, mirror X, and now you have it across both. Now, something cool you can do, say you want to keep the back of the leg separate because it's like some hydraulics or whatever. Really easy way is to copy this, and then you can just paste. Basically, turn everything off, okay? And then, you know, paste this. It's going to have an X mirror. And you'll see it didn't mirror right away because it's not, one thing it doesn't copy is the lock position, lock size. So you might want to do that and then paste. And now you have it. So it basically, it copy and pasted the settings. It just didn't, the pivot point was in the wrong place, if that makes any sense. All right, that's it for this one. I just wanted to showcase the local, the dual cross x-axis symmetry that you can get with ray mesh. And there's a few more things I want to show in one more video. I'll put it out as soon as possible. But check the link in the description. I'm going to show you where I actually learned this in another one of those long presentations. So check their video out as well. It's Paul Gabry, I think, from the ZBrush gods. Or the... I'm not sure if it was a summit or a guide, but anyways, all right, catch you later.